'Cause I'm gonna set this house on.
Initiative.
Since you're running for
lovely
the hills,
to Taylor. City having the better of it. The drill. Can't get the ball under control.
The only shoots
like a ball in a China shop. Been a late comeback already in the National Premier Queensland today, but you'll need the ball to make a late comeback. And
the minute that I walk in, you're trying to hold me down. Gotta shake your claws in till I'm face back on the ground. Don't know what you've been drinking. Every time you come around, so let me down. If that's the way it's gonna be, leave your shiny yellow key on the doorstep and start burning up your ties and take your coat again. Shake the shirt right off my back, I don't mind, 'cause I'm gonna set this house on.
Another episode of the 10,000 Hours Project. You've just seen a compilation of some footage that I've compiled together over the last five or six games that I've had with my new team, Cairns FC. And I keep saying this over and over, but it's been an absolutely overwhelming experience with my new team so far, playing in the National Premier League. It's the sixth game that I've played with my new team, and I've got six starts. I've played every single minute of every game. Now, I really feel like I'm starting to settle down into the team. I'm starting to get used to the players around me. I'm starting to get used to how the coach wants me to play. And most of all, I feel like my fitness levels are starting to increase as well, which gives me more opportunity to train individually. Now, I feel like I'm starting to get into the spaces where I can finally distribute the ball and get it towards my more attacking players. But I still got some issues here and there with my body positioning, opening up and really being that anchor as a number six. You know, I've lost possession a few times with the ball, but you know, I'll work on that over the next couple of weeks and just analysing my game footage. Overall, it's been a pretty decent start to life in the National Premier League. I mean, I think the last three games we've been on plane trips to Brisbane, playing teams in and around the city. And again, just bringing that professional feeling, you know, I don't have to pay for plane tickets, food, accommodation, anything like that. It's all been paid for by the team. There have been times at the airport where you walk past and you get random people in the public saying, oh, how'd you go with your game? Or good luck for your game. And getting photos with a few fans as well. I mean, like I said, it's been an absolutely amazing experience so far. Now, to bring you up to date with my training hours, I've completed 3,652 hours as of today, and today is a Monday. We had our game on Saturday against Brisbane City and we won 3-1, which pushes us up into sixth position on the National Premier League ladder. Now, we need to make top four if we'll have any chance of making finals. Reflecting on my own individual fitness, currently my legs are feeling dead. I was supposed to have a recovery day yesterday. It kind of was, but I played like a little pickup slash little mini World Cup tournament that was on in the local area. But I got team training tonight for about an hour and a half, but before that I'm going to go in and do another general conditioning session. I'm going to end the video on the individual session, and before I go, obviously please hit that like button, subscribe if you're new to this space, and comment down below your training logs, guys. Also keep a keen eye out over the next few days for an upcoming vlog where we'll be announcing if we get to draw an A-League side in the round of 32 for the FFA Cup in Australia. It'll be absolutely an amazing experience if you get to draw an A-League side. Anyway guys, until then, keep that training going, keep consistent with it. It's the only way to achieve results, and that's exactly what I'm doing and documenting with the 10,000 Hours Project. Alright guys, I'll see you on the next vlog. Catch you later.